Hello everyone. Today in this video, we'll learn some question from the chapter number system. From class 9 syllabus. And in this video, we'll learn how to convert decimals into fraction. As we know that if any number has point, then we consider that number to be decimal. Like suppose 2.5, this number can be called as decimal. And fraction means suppose if there is a number which is 2 by 5, that means in fraction there should be numerator as well as denominator. So this type of number can be called as decimal, and that type of number can be called as fraction. So in this video we'll learn some this kind of question. So if you are not subscribed this channel, then please subscribe so that you can learn, and you watch the complete video so that you can learn how can you convert decimals into fraction. So this is from exercise 1C from Meghalaya Mathematics. So in question number 1, there is a question which is 0.61. This is a decimal, so we have to convert this decimal into fraction. So if we convert this decimal into fraction, first what we'll have to see, we have to see after point how many digits are there. If we see here, there are 2 digits, then what we'll have to do in the denominator, after putting 1, since there is 2 digits, so there will be 2 number of 0. Then we have to write the number without the point, that means it is 61. Now if we remove this point from here, then this 0 doesn't have any value, that is why we don't write 0 here. So this is the fraction. Now in question number 2, there is a question that is 3.35. So this is also decimal. Now we'll convert this into fraction. So we can see here after point there is 2 number of digits, so after 1 there will be 2 number of 0. Then we'll have to write this number without the point, that is 335. Now since both the numerator and denominator are divisible by 5, so we'll have to divide it by 5. If we divide this 100 with 5, we'll get 20 times. That means in the denominator there will be 20. Then if we divide this 335 with 5, it is 335. If we divide by 5, then we'll get 5 6 are 30. Here will be 3 as remainder. Then 5 here, 5 7s are 35. So the remainder is 0. So here we are getting 67. That means 67 by 20. Now we cannot divide anymore. So this is the fraction. So that means this decimal, if we convert into fraction, we will get 67 by 20. So this is the way the rest of the question can be solved. Now we'll move to question number 3. In question number 3, there is question that is 0.6 bar. So before solving this question, first we'll understand what this bar means. This bar means this 6 is repeating again and again. Like suppose there is 0.6 bar, that means it will be like 0.666. It is repeating again and again. That means this number will just keep coming on. One after another. That means this number cannot be terminating. It will just be non-terminating and the number will just going on. So in that case, if we try to solve like we have learned in the previous question, like suppose if we see that after decimal, how many digits are there? it is unlimited number of 6. So if we put 1, then we cannot put unlimited number of zeros like this. So that is why this question cannot be solved in the previous method. So we'll have to solve in different method. So we'll try to solve in different method. In that method, we'll have to make two equations. So one equation will be without repeating digit. Another one will be with repeating digit. So this is the two rule we need to follow here. Now how we'll solve this question? First we'll consider this 0.6 bar as x. So let x is equal to 0.6 bar. That means if there is bar, this 6 is repeating again and again. So we can write it again, x equal to 0.6666, like this. Now if we see this equation, in this equation we can see before the decimal, whatever the number is there, this number is not repeating. So in the first equation, we have to write the number before the decimal here without repeating digits. So here we can see this 0 is not repeating again and again. So our first condition is fulfilled. So we can put this equation as equation number 1. And in the second equation, again we'll write the same equation. X is equal to 0.666 dot dot dot. And the same number we are writing again. One more 6 we can give. So we are writing the same equation again. Now in this equation, what we'll have to see, we have to put the number, repeating number, before the decimal. Like in the second condition we have with repeating digit. So here this 6 in the previous equation, this 6 is repeating and 0 is non-repeating, so before decimal there is 0. But in this equation we have to put one repeating digit before the decimal. That means if we want to put any of the repeating digit before the 0, so here we can see the repeating digit is 6. So that means this 6 will come here in the place of 0. So it indirectly means this point will move one digit that side. So if we move this point one digit that side, here if we move the point, then this 0 doesn't have any value, so we can remove this 0. Now if we see, if we compare with the previous equation, here the point was here and in the next equation the point has moved one digit. The point has moved how many digit? One digit. Since the point has moved one digit, so in the left hand side after one we need to multiply a single zero, one number of zero, because the digit has, the point has been repeated, point has been moved one digit. So that is why one number of 0, and we'll put this as equation number 2. What we'll have to do, that is we'll have to subtract this equation 1 from equation 2. So we'll have to write by subtracting 1 from 2, we'll get, first we will write equation number 2 because we are going to subtract equation 1 from 2. So equation number 2 is 10x is equal to 6.6666. This is equation number 2. Then equation number 1 is x is equal to 0.6666. This is equation number 1. If we subtract here, these are the repeating digit, that are the repeating digit, and this 6 is repeating again and again. So if we subtract, we'll get 0. Then point here, so after point, if there is 0, we don't need to put the point. So 6 minus 0 is 6 here, is equal to, since there is 10x and here is x, so x means it is actually 1x, so we can consider this as 1x. So 10x minus 1x is 9x. So here we are getting 9x is equal to 6. Then if we put this 9 on the right hand side, since this 9 is multiplied in the left hand side, if we put it on the right hand side, it will be divided. So x will be equal to 6 divided by 9. So the fraction is 6 by 9. You can convert this kind of decimal into fraction. So we'll try one more question. That is from question number 4. So the first one is without repeating, second one is with repeating. So in question number 4, there is a question that is 0.37 bar. Now if we compare this question with the previous question we have solved, we can see here in this question there is bar over 2 digit. So since it is on 2 digit, that means this 2 digit is repeating like this. Actually it is 0.3737 3737 3737. The number is just going on like this. So if the bar is on 2 digit, if 2 digit is repeating, then how we need to solve, we'll learn here. So let again x is equal to 0.37 bar. So since 2 digit is repeating, so we need to mention it here, 0.373737 dot dot dot. Now in the first condition there is without repeating digit, so here the number before the decimal is without repeating, so we can consider this as equation number 1. And now we need to take the repeating digit before the decimal. So again we will write the same equation, x equal to 0.37373737. In this case what we will do, since two number of digit is repeating here, so we will move this point after 2 digit. So before the point was here, now we will move it 2 digit there. Then this 0 and the point will be removed. So since we have moved 2 digit, this point has been moved 2 digit on the right, so here after 1 there will be 2 number of zeros multiplied, because the point has moved 2 digit towards the right, so 2 number of zeros with 1 will be multiplied with x. So we can see here 100x is equal to 37.37 37 37. So this one can be written as equation number 2. Again we will subtract 2 minus 1, so what we'll get, 100x is equal to 37.37 37 37. This is equation number 2. And in equation number 1 there is x is equal to 0.37 37 37. This is equation number 1. So if we subtract, so all these numbers are same, so it will be 0. So point, if there is 0 after point, point doesn't have any value. So 37 minus 0 is 37, is equal to 100 minus 100x minus 1x is 99x. Now if we put this 99 on the right hand side, since this 99 is multiplied with x, it will be divided, so it is 37 by x, oh, 37 by 99, sorry. So this is the fraction. If we divide, we'll get this kind of decimal. So if this kind of decimals are there, we can convert into fraction in this method. So we'll try to learn one more question, that is from question number 5. Suppose there is a question that is 0.53, the bar is on 3. Here only 3 is repeating. Here both this 5 and 3 is not repeating, only 3 is repeating. So in this case, how we'll have to solve, we'll learn it. So let x is equal to 0.531, x is equal to 0.533333. Dot dot dot. Now if we see in this equation, here this 5 is not repeating, but this is after the decimal. So that means we need without repeating digit before the decimal. But in this equation, it is not in the form of that condition. So what we'll have to do? We have to first put this non-repeating digit before the decimal. So we'll write in the same way again, 0.533333. Then what we'll do? Since this 5 is not repeating, we'll first satisfy the first condition. So in the first condition, what is there? Without repeating digit should be before the decimal. That means this decimal should be moved one digit that side. So this point will be here. Now if we see, those the digits which is not repeating, that is before the decimal. Now, since we have moved one digit that side, we have moved this point one digit that side, so one number of zero will be multiplied. So this now can be considered as the first equation. And in the second equation, what we'll have to do? We'll have to write the first equation in the same way, is equal to 5.3333. Okay. Now what we'll see? In the second condition, there is without repeating digit. That means the decimal will move one digit. Since one digit is repeating, so the decimal will move here because this 3 is repeating. Now in the second condition, it is with repeating digit. So the point will move here. If the point moves here, then we need to remove the point from there. Now we are getting 53.3. Since the point has moved in this equation one digit on the right hand side, to the right hand side, so one number of zeros will be included here. So this will be equation number 2. Now again, equation number 2 minus equation number 1, what will get? So 100x is equal to 53.333, equation number 2. Then minus 10x is equal to, since 5.33 we have to maintain this point just straight below the point, then 3 3 3 and 5 here. So if we subtract 0.333, 0.330, so 13 minus 5 is 8, then 1 has taken there, so 4 minus 0 is 4, is equal to, now 100x minus 10x is 90x. Now if we put this 90 on the right hand side, it will be divided, 48 by 90. If we cancel it with 2, then we'll get 24 time, and here 45 time. Again, if we divide it by 3, since it is divisible by 3, 3 is 24 and 3 15 is 45. So we'll get 8 by 15 here. So this is the fraction which is equal to the decimal 0.53 bar.